So you sit down to build a website, and 5 minutes later, you're stuck. Should you start with a template? What about SEO? And then we haven't even gotten to the design of it. You might even have a really clear idea of what the website should look like, but actually making that happen is where things start to get shaky. So in this video, I'm gonna give you a simple 5-step framework that I've used for over a decade to build client sites. And I'm gonna show you how to do it by redesigning my own site because it's way overdue. Are you ready? Let's go. The first question that most people ask when they build a website is how? How should I build it? Should I use a website builder or maybe code it from scratch? What about a template? Should I use one of those? You might even have searched the best website builder for fill in the blank. But here's the truth. That's actually the wrong question. The real question is, what's the goal of my website? Because the goal determines everything. What you should build, how you should build it, and what the website actually needs. When I work with clients, I actually start with a questionnaire to get super clear on their site's primary goals. You can actually grab this exact questionnaire for free. The link's in the description. So for this website, I actually filled out the questionnaire for myself since it's my website. And here's what I realized. The main goal of the self-made web designer website is really simple. I want people to sign up, either for a free resource, maybe a newsletter, but it all starts with an email address. So that's the goal that I'm building around. Thankfully for this kind of site, I don't need to code anything from scratch. I'm perfectly fine to use a website builder. And because I'm trying to impress other web designers, I can't build from a template. I have to build it from scratch. So the game plan right now is building something from scratch with a website builder. Now, I know that there are a ton of options out there for website builders. So let's break down a few of the most popular. First, Webflow. Webflow is really powerful and it's packed with a lot of features. You can create some seriously cool stuff with it, but it comes with a really steep learning curve. And if you want to do anything outside of its native features, you're probably going to need to code a little bit. Framer is a little bit easier to learn. And it comes with beautiful sites right out of the box, but it's missing some flexibility. Like if you wanted to sell digital products or build a custom checkout page, I'd have to embed something like Shopify or Gumroad. And that means giving up a lot of control over the design. But there's a third option, a platform that you might not have heard of that actually gives me the best of both worlds. And it's called Showit. It works kind of like Canva, easy to use, fully drag and drop. But here's the kicker. It integrates with WordPress, which means if there's a plugin for it, you can do it on Showit. And that also means that as my business grows or expands or changes, I don't have to do a lot of development or potentially hire someone to help me. So this is the perfect solution for the goal of my website. Now that the platform's picked, it's time to hop into Showit and start designing, right? Not so fast. When I first started building websites, I made this mistake all the time. I jumped straight into designing the homepage, only to hear from clients that it looked nothing like what they had in mind. The same is true if you're building your own website. That's why now I start slow, I start simple, and I build up complexity gradually. So the thing that I start with after I've picked my platform is called a mood board. Your mood board is going to help you determine things like maybe your typography or the font styles that you're going to use, the colors that your website will have, maybe the layouts of different section or different layout ideas, and even the pages that the site will have. But here's the thing. Once you have all these things down, you basically have everything you need to build a killer website. There are all kinds of different ways to approach building a mood board. Some designers build a really detailed Figma file, and others just kind of pin stuff to a private Pinterest board. Both work, but I've found that building a mood board from scratch might take a while, and a Pinterest board might not be detailed enough. So there's a lot of gaps that are going to be missing. But something that makes all of this incredibly easy is a tool called Reloom. It actually uses AI to do everything that we just talked about automatically. So it's going to give you all the pages that you need. It's going to help you find fonts and colors and help you with layout ideas. You actually just give it a few details about your business or project, and it instantly generates a full site map with page level wireframing suggestions, and then even brand styles like font combos and color palettes. And the best part is you can actually tweak everything until it fits exactly what you have a vision for. It's like having a creative partner that just gives you a massive head start. There's a free plan available, and if you want to try the premium features, they've got a 7-day free trial. I'll drop the link in the description if you want to check it out. So we got our mood board all set for the new self-made web designer site. Now it's time to move on to the next step, which is designing the homepage. So first things first, let's set up our design system inside Showit. A design system is just a set of rules for things like your fonts, your colors, and even things like buttons and how they're displayed and look. I've got some of this dialed in from the graphics from the Self-Made Web Designer YouTube channel, and I want the site to feel similar to the channel so people don't feel like they're in the wrong place. So for the display fonts, or the fonts that I'm gonna use for like my titles and headers, I'm using a font called PP Write Grotesque. And that comes from the Pangram Studio, which is a great font resource. Then for the paragraph fonts, I'm actually using the Aeonic family. And the colors are really simple. We're talking about gray, black, white, and this yellow. And I'll probably use a few different shades of that gray, so it gives me some options later on. The good news is that Showit actually lets you define all of your global styles in the design settings. So we're gonna add all of our colors, and then come through, add our fonts, make them exactly how we want them to be. My title fonts are gonna be about 150 pixels big, and that's because I really like big fonts. I feel like there could be a song written called I Like Big Fonts, and I can't not lie, but I'm gonna spare you from that. So then I'll come through and add all my paragraph fonts as well as my subheading and my heading fonts. Now that the design settings are all finished, I'm gonna start building out all of the sections that I need for my homepage. And within Showit, we do that by adding blank canvases. And then we can come in and change the name of each of these canvases so that we can know exactly what it is that we're working with. Now, every homepage needs a few sections. It needs a navigation and a footer, but there's also this fun little section that we need to add called the hero. The hero is arguably the most important section of your website. This is the first section that people see when your site fully loads, and you've got about 3 seconds to convince someone that your website was actually worth the click that they just gave you. Every hero needs at least 3 things. It needs a motivating header, a clarifying subheader, and then a crystal clear next step that the user should take. And then for good measure, you should probably throw in something beautiful like a image or some type of design element. As you start to look at other websites with a critical eye, you'll notice that most of them follow this exact pattern. So on this site, here's the header, here's the subheading, and here's that next step. And then they've got some images thrown in as well. So let's come back in to Showit. Let's make our navigation just a little bit smaller, and then we're gonna make our hero section a little bit bigger. That kind of follows the patterns that we saw on the other websites. And I always like to start with the headline on my hero section, because that's the quickest indicator that your visitors are actually in the right space. So within Showit, we're gonna add our title, because that's the header of the hero section. And then we're gonna start thinking about, what does our specific audience want the most? And for me, my audience wants to learn web design quickly. So that's exactly what I'm gonna add as my headline here. How to learn web design fast. It's clear, it's motivating, and it's something that people are actually going to search for on Google. You also want to make sure that you're designing the mobile version of your homepage as you're designing the desktop. So many folks think about how their site looks on mobile devices as kind of an afterthought, but it actually needs to be a priority because a lot of your website visitors are going to find you on mobile first. Thankfully, Show It gives you the option to see the desktop and the mobile version of your site at the same time. Next, I'm gonna move to the subheading. And this is where I get really clear on the value that I'm hoping to offer people who visit my site. So we wanna be thinking about things like the what, the why, and the how of how I'm gonna deliver what I offered them in this headline, how to learn web design fast. So I'll probably add something like web design courses, tutorials, and podcasts that'll help you ditch the frustrating job, build a side hustle, grow your income, and be your own boss. Seems great. I'll come through and fix some of these typos here, but we're off to a fantastic start. After the subheading's done, you need a crystal clear next step. And that's where something called a CTA or call to action comes in. It's actually just a button that tells your visitors exactly what to do next. You never want them to wonder like, okay, what now, right? You've got to show them that next step. So for me, I want people to sign up for my newsletter. So that's exactly what I'm going to add here. Instead of learn more, we want it to be really clear. Sign up for my newsletter. Super clear, super easy to understand, gives them exactly the next thing that they should be doing. And hey, I know we're talking a lot about copy right now, and if you're struggling knowing what you should write, or maybe your client didn't give you copy, Reloom can actually write out the copy for you. Just go back to your wireframe, select the section that you're working on, and then click generate copy. You can even add a short description that works as a prompt. This entire time, I'm actually playing around with layouts to see what feels the best and flows more naturally for the user. So maybe I'll try text on the left with an image on the right, or vice versa. But for my website, I actually just want to keep everything straight up and down the middle. So let me adjust that here. Thankfully, Show It makes it really easy for you just to kind of center align everything without having to guess at where the exact center actually is. So let me do that with this button as well, size and position. And that's already kind of the case over on the mobile version. And that makes it that much easier because we're already aligned with what we're doing on the desktop. Let me give it a little bit of space down here, pull this down. Now, I don't just want to have a stock image here in the hero section. I want to have an image of myself because hopefully the goal is people from YouTube come to visit my website, and how are they going to know they're in the right place without there being a picture of me? So let me double click on this. We'll change out to this headshot. And then I'm actually going to round these corners just a little bit to add some soft edges. Now, one final element that I want to add to the hero section is something that I've seen a lot of on some really cool websites. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So you can see here on this site, there's these grids that when you kind of hover over them, they interact with you just a tad bit. And same for this website as well. Now, is this necessary? Probably not, but it adds a little bit of visual appeal. Now, let me go back over here to Show It, and then we're going to open our media library, and I've already kind of put a grid here. I'm actually just going to make this really big because I want it to cover a lot of space. So let's move everything to the center, and then we'll put our Y coordinates up here. And then let's go ahead and turn down the opacity on this so it's not quite as sharp. And then we'll do the same thing over on the mobile version of things. So about 1538, that's looking pretty good. And then we'll bring the Y coordinate up to 0 so it's at the very top. So I am really pleased with how this is starting to look. So now that the hero section feels right, it's time to add the other sections of our homepage. So we're gonna add some more blank canvases, And maybe this section we talk about the value, and then maybe we add another one. And this section, we're gonna add a little bit of social proof. So people that have said nice things about me. Thank you to those people, if that's one of you. Once you got that first version of the homepage built, it's time to bring in a fresh pair of eyes, because here's the thing. You've probably been staring at this for a while. You know where everything is, you know what it all means and how it works. That's actually called the curse of knowledge. And it makes you miss out on things that are glaringly obvious to everyone else. So that's why the revision step is absolutely crucial. Who do you ask for feedback? Well, if you're working with a client, they probably want to have a say in how things are shaping up. But if it's for your personal site, don't just send it to your mom or your closest designer friend. Instead, look for a few people, ideally ones who don't know all that much about your business, and give them specific things to look for. Here are the questions that I always tend to ask. Does the headline make sense immediately, right? That's super important. Is it clear what the site is about? Do you know what to do next? Does it look good on mobile? All of these questions are going to guide you in the right path. Since I'm a little too close to this project, I actually had a friend go through the self-made homepage and give me his honest thoughts. Once your homepage passes the test, you're ready to build out the rest of the site. And this is the final step in this framework. But I always recommend starting with just the essentials and then adding more later. So the must-have pages are your about page and your contact page. Some nice-to-have pages are things like services or products, maybe resources or portfolio, depending on your actual goal, maybe a blog as well. Thankfully, the hard part is already done. The homepage set the tone, the style, and the structure. All the remaining pages are just kind of remixing what's already been built. Here's the key though, don't overthink it. You can always come back and improve pages later on. I followed these exact steps, the same ones that I just walked you through, to go from this to this. Hello. Why do they doubt the kid? I'm about to prove them all wrong again. I got a low tolerance because they don't even know what their problem is. It's me. And the best part is, I didn't code it by hand. It didn't take me a ton of hours. If you want to see how each section and page turned out, head to selfmadewebdesigner.com to see the final product. And hey, if this video has helped you, make sure to hit that like button, drop a comment, and subscribe, because I've got a ton more coming your way. Go out there, build an amazing website, and don't forget, if you don't quit, you win.